Hello. This is the second video of electronic component research series. Among electronic components sold on Amazon, I'll look into resistors. I'm going to check their quality. I picked up two sets of resistors with good reviews on Amazon. Let's see the quality of these two. I picked up products from two companies so I can get more reliable results. This is from Longruner, and this is from Elegoo. I don't think these companies manufacture resistors on their own. Elegoo is a manufacturer of 3D printers, and Longruner's, I'm not sure. They sell electronic components and stuff. Not sure about the details, but I guess they both buy a huge number of electronic components, repack, and resell them. I open the packages. Both are precision resistors. Their tolerance is plus or minus 1%. I'll see if the tolerance is correct. They seem to be resistors for those who work on electronics as a hobby. Resistors with various resistance values are packaged in small quantities. If you buy one, you won't have to buy new resistors for the time being. I will open the Elegoo kit first. They are packaged neatly. There's an explanation of color codes. Nice. Mostly 25 resistors per resistance value, but there are 50 for commonly used values. Elegoo resistors are not cheap, so the packaging is neatly done. Next is Longruner. All resistors are put in a single bag. 20 resistors per resistance value. Compared to the Elegoo kit, resistance values vary a lot more, so Longruner kit is of wider use. If you don't have the resistors with the resistance value you want, you can create one by connecting resistors in series or in parallel. But with this Longruner kit, you won't have to do that. Let's take a closer look at the resistors from each company. Both are 1 kilo ohm resistors. The thickness of the lead wires is quite different. Longruner wires are thin, but Elegoo wires are thick. Lead wire materials are also different. Elegoo 1 doesn't stick to the magnet. I guess the wire's core is made of copper or aluminum. As for Longruner, it sticks to the magnet. The core is made of iron. There are various types of lead wires. Some wire's core is made of iron, and some core is made of copper. Iron core is less costly. Then, what's good about the copper core? It has high conductivity. However, copper is more expensive than iron. Iron is cheaper. Why don't lead wires have copper color? That's because the surface is plated, with tin. The cut surface of the lead wire we saw earlier had the color of copper, so I think the core is copper. It's plated with tin. Next, I'm going to measure the resistance values as you all may want to know. I'll use this device. I'll use four-terminal method, also known as Kelvin method, which is commonly used to measure resistance values. I bought this 6.5-digit digital multimeter a year and 4 months ago, but I'll use this anyway. I'm measuring the resistance of a 1 kilo ohm metal film resistor with plus or minus 0.1% tolerance. 0.1% tolerance means that the resistance must be between 999 and 1,001 ohm, and it is within the range. You need to put wires on the lead wire to measure the resistance. It's time-consuming, so I made a jig to improve the efficiency of the process. Attach clips on these copper wires and push the resistor against the wires. Then you can measure the resistance instantly. After measuring resistance using this jig, I recorded the values using a histogram to see the distribution against the rated tolerance. The horizontal axis represents the error rate. The vertical axis represents the number of resistors with each error rate. All the resistors from Elegoo have resistance error rate within the range of plus or minus 1%. There were only 50 samples, but the histogram shows a normal distribution. With this little number of samples, I can't say for sure, but Elegoo's products seem to be stable in quality. These are 220 ohm resistors. I did the same experiment on 1 kilo ohm and 47 kilo ohm resistors. They were also within the range of plus or minus 1%. The graph shows a normal distribution. If you add more samples, I think the graph will show a normal distribution with a tolerance of plus or minus 1%. Also, there will be less resistors with nearly 0% error rate, because such resistors will be distributed to different packages labeled with lower tolerance. I guess the graph will look like this if you add more samples. Why so little number of resistors with nearly 0% error rate? I guess they put such resistors in packages labeled with lower tolerance, such as 0.5 or 0.1%. Well, that's what I would do. I wouldn't sell the ones in this range as 1% tolerance products. Next, we'll look at Longruner. We only have 20 samples at hand, even fewer than Elegoo. I measured the resistance values, and they are not in the range of plus or minus 1%. The rated tolerance is 1%, but there were resistors with higher error rates. Also, the values vary a lot. The graph doesn't form a normal distribution shape. I had only 20 samples, so I can't say this for sure, but Longruner doesn't seem to be stable in quality. Next, let's see how the resistance value changes with the temperature. I'll use this Elegoo resistor with 1 kilo ohm resistance. Let's see how the value changes if I apply hot air using a hot air gun. There, the value decreased. This resistor seems to have negative temperature coefficient. I'll apply hot air again. The resistance value decreased again. As for metal materials, if you heat it up, the resistance value increases because it has positive coefficient. However, if you read the datasheet carefully, the coefficient is rated in the range that includes both positive and negative values. That means the resistance value may increase or decrease when the temperature rises. Whether the value increases or decreases depends on the manufacturing lot and the material used for the resistor. There are many factors. As for this resistor's lot, the coefficient is negative. I checked another resistor I have, a 100 ohm resistor from Koa, made in Japan. Let's apply hot air. The resistance value increased. The coefficient is positive for this resistor's lot. Next, we'll look at the power rating. All resistors I bought this time are rated 0.25 watts. Considering Ohm's law, the maximum voltage I can apply is the square root of 0.25 watts times. Let's say the resistance is 100 ohm, so I can apply a voltage of 5 volts. Realistically, it's unlikely to apply the rated voltage to a 0.25 watts resistor. Let's give it a try. This is a 0.25 watts resistor. Turn on the power supply, then connect to the resistor. It's heating up. Be sure to check the set voltage before connecting a resistor. I applied 30 volts just now, and the resistor is completely burned. The appropriate voltage is 5 volts. This time, I applied the rated voltage. The resistor is only a bit warm. I didn't cut the lead wires, so the heat is dissipated well. As with carbon film resistors, metal film resistors also burns if you apply voltage way higher than the rated voltage. Can you see? At first, smoke comes out. Then if you apply even higher voltage, it starts burning. The second video of electronic component research series was about the quality of the resistors sold on Amazon. My impression is that these are good enough for people who work on electronics as a hobby. The quality seems to depend more on which company manufactured the resistors rather than which company repacked and resold them. Especially one of the two companies we've seen this time, Longruner. They package a large variety of resistors, which is good, but the error rates are not within plus or minus 1%. If you still want it with that in mind, then you should buy it. As for Elegoo, the error rates are within plus or minus 1%. Also, the lead wires in the packaging are good. Overall, the product is of high quality. Again, the company that manufactured the resistors is more important than the company that sells them. However, buyers don't have any means to tell which company manufactured the resistors or whether they applied quality control measures. I hope this video will be of some help to choose the right product. I don't think you would buy resistors to be used for industrial products. But if you do, be aware that some products' error rates are not within the rated tolerance. I bought metal film resistors this time. In the case of carbon film resistors, a package of 100 resistors costs about 100 to 300 yen at a retail store. If you buy a set product like the ones we saw today, you can get a variety of resistance values for a cheaper price, even though the number of resistors per resistance value is smaller. So there are merits in buying this kind of products.